Big Brother, mainstream media, government cover-ups. You want answers? Well, so does he. He's Alex Jones on the GCN Radio Network. And now, live from Austin, Texas, Alex Jones.
Thank you for joining us. We've reached the halfway point in this Wednesday, December 30th, 2009 edition. We're simulcasting now the third and fourth hour live at PrisonPlanet.tv. I'm going to go over the decade of tyranny, an article written by Paul Watson, Steve Watson, and myself at PrisonPlanet.com. In the last hour, I'm also going to spend a segment or so reading some quotes by George Washington and talking about why King George III called him the greatest man in the world. Why did King George III call him the greatest man in the world? Because he turned down the power when he was offered kingship. In fact, the British wanted a king to deal with. They were just going to set him up as a new house of nobility. And he said no. And he didn't want to be president. Now, no one in history has acted and behaved like that. That's why our country had the best start ever. This great engine of liberty has been turned into an engine of tyranny. Former Wall Street Journal editor, former head of policy, the father of Reaganomics, headed up the Treasury, Dr. Paul Craig Roberts, best-selling author. The latest edition is out, The Tyranny of Good Intentions. He joins us for the rest of the hour. We're going to get into the tyranny, the body scanners, the police state, then into the dollar, the economy. His predictions again come true. He said a month ago here the dollar would go back up when the carry trade got reversed, but he said it would then go back down. Well, hear when that's going to happen. With us for the rest of the hour, Dr. Paul Craig Roberts. But first, you wanted to talk about Hedges' column. Tell us about that, sir.
Okay, Alex. I think the greatest threat that we face is the ongoing destruction of the United States Constitution and our civil liberties. They're now holding, you know, American citizens in indefinite detention, denying American citizens habeas corpus to process. And they're doing it without any evidence presented and without really any charges. They orchestrate the most blatantly false kinds of charges. Let's take the case of this Farhad Hashmi. Now, he's an American citizen. I think it was in New York. He was a known Muslim activist in behalf of civil rights for Muslims. He was not a terrorist. He's not involved in any of that. He's been arrested and held now for, I think, 2.5 years. I can't remember.
Yeah, it's almost three.
3 years, okay. Because allegedly, someone he knew stayed in his apartment, and allegedly this person was collecting up ponchos and socks to take to give to the Taliban. And, I mean, the whole thing sounds far-fetched. I mean, why would somebody be trying to take socks and ponchos to the Taliban from New York? I mean, that's...
As if they can't buy it in Pakistan. A lot of the ponchos and socks that come here are from Pakistan, India,
right,
China. But on top of that, someone claims with no evidence, three or four deep, that maybe you let somebody stay with you who might have done something wrong and you disappear into a black hole as a U.S. citizen.
That's exactly what's happened. You summed it up good for me. I just finished reading the uncensored version of Alexander Solzhenitsyn in the First Circle. About the Stalinist camps and legal system. And if you read that book and then you read Chris Hedges' description of the American legal system, it's no different. What's happening to us is exactly what was ongoing in Stalinist Russia. People are just picked up and locked away. They just disappear. And there's
well,
no
stay there, sir. I want you to take your time. Let's get into Solzhenitsyn's First Circle of Hell. Gulag Archipelago author. Nobel Prize winner, somebody who actually deserved it. What, 9 years in a gulag, or was it 8 years?
This is Alan.